to take things out of order tonight, and because we have a number of people with us from the Fisk School, so I'm going to turn the meeting over to Mrs. Palmer at this time.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Berry. So it is always a pleasure when we bring the arts to a school board meeting, and Fisk School is here to present for us this evening. If you recall, last spring, I believe it was, Soul School was here, and they presented on their presentation, their annual theatrical production, Off Their Rockers. And so Fisk School is going to talk about their program that they run annually. It's a spring production, and they're going to take us through the journey from auditions right down to the performance. So I will begin with Mr. Murray, the principal of Fisk School.
Thank you, Mrs. Palmer. And I first want to start by thanking the board for inviting us this evening. And to mention, this is our opportunity to thank you for your continued support of us as a staff. And you really make our jobs easy to do because, well, not easy to do, but you support us, and that means a lot to all of us. So I'm speaking on the behalf of the staff. We enjoy this opportunity each year to come and show the board the many things that we do, and in this particular case, we feel that we really do well in this program that we're going to share with you tonight. It also provides our staff an opportunity to come out and support our teammates and also our students. So thank you for this opportunity. So Children's Stage Adventures is a week-long residency program offered to our students in grades K-5. Where kids direct and perform a complete musical production from soup to nuts, from the beginning to the end, where two professional teachers actually come out to the Fisk community and actually live for the week with our families. So one of our Fisk families will open their home to these two teachers, and then they'll work during the day at our end into the evening with our students and stay with the families at night. So it's a really a combination of school and our community supporting the program. Our goal for you tonight is to share what CSA truly is and what it looks like at Fisk School and the impact that it has on our students. We have actually three students that we're going to follow through their journey when they were in the primary grades, and now they're currently fifth graders. So you're going to see them grow from little tykes to now fifth graders, and they're here in the audience. In addition, we sought out a freshman, a current freshman at Salem High School, who started her acting career at Fisk School as a fifth grader. And she's now participating in the high school program, and you'll see her in the video. So we're excited to share that. In just a few moments, Mr. Rose has some comments to make, as we often look forward to annually. And he's going to speak about the importance of arts in a child's education. And at the conclusion, Mrs. Dufour, who is our Children's Stage Adventure coordinator, she'll be available to answer any questions, as she is the one that truly organizes it in our building. So at this time, we're going to start with a brief trailer to give you a sense of what CSA is.
A surprise for me? How nice!
Guess what it is?
Children's Stage Adventures is an artist-in-residency program that has visited Fisk each year for the past 5 years. Each year we're able to include every student that has been interested in performing. So whether they are a kindergartner in the chorus or a fourth or fifth grader with a lead role, everyone gets to participate. We really spend the whole week focused on getting these students ready for Friday's performance.
Happy New Year, and thanks for having us. We always enjoy the opportunity to share Fisk School's successes with the board. It's a pleasure to take time on this winter night to introduce you to our Children's Stage Adventures theatrical productions. This annual April tradition is a sure sign of spring's arrival, and so much more. Others more qualified than I will present the impressive details shortly, but this is key. In each of the past 5 years, an amazing piece of musical theater has been cast, rehearsed, and performed twice, once for the school and again for the community. There are costumes, multiple sets, music, and always large and enthusiastic audiences. Many volunteers assist Fisk staff, and well over half of our students participate. It is ambitious for sure, and it happens as if by magic over the course of just 5 school days. From tryouts and casting on Monday to spectacular performances on Friday, these plays are much more than unforgettable entertainment. Through these memorable shows, which are an exciting mix of movement, music, and story, audience and actors alike are enriched. Here's how. The American Alliance for Theater and Education cites various studies that identify the strong link between participation in theater arts and academic achievement. Students who participate in drama performances and coursework tend to outscore non-art students on both the verbal and math components of the SAT. Reading comprehension, communication skills, attendance rates, and overall engagement with school are improved for these students as well. A Boston Globe editorial from January 2nd titled "Make Arts Education Standard" drew strikingly similar conclusions. It states, quote, "Beyond teaching students about public performance or painting techniques, arts programs also deepen students' involvement in their own education. Clearly, theater is a positive influence on academics. Does it nurture other qualities as well?" Humanitarian and Holocaust survivor Elie Wiesel once suggested that God made man because he loves stories. The book, The Storytelling Animal, makes a plausible claim that stories are elemental to being human. We dream, think, and relate to each other through story. Theater is storytelling. It is glorious storytelling, so often accompanied by music and dance. Any of us lucky enough to have sat in a darkened theater, thoroughly captivated by the sights and sounds from the stage, would agree that theatrical performances connect to something primal in all of us. Just before the Kennedy Center Honors Celebration Concert in early December, President Obama introduced this year's recipients. Saluting the talents of such legendary performers as James Taylor, Mavis Staples, Al Pacino, and the Eagles, he described the artists as, quote, "folks who spent their lives calling on us to think a little harder, feel a little deeper, and express ourselves a little more bravely." The president was acknowledging that the value of the performing arts go far beyond the entertainment and spectacle. Paintings, drama, poetry, literature, song and dance, art of any type pushes those who experience it to see the world with greater richness. Patrons of the arts, including theater, benefit greatly from their experiences. Values and culture are transmitted, perspectives are expanded or even challenged, and we derive pleasure. Even high ticket prices are a bargain in light of what is gained. And the performers, in addition to applause, they gain confidence, poise, and self-discipline. They build skills of cooperation, collaboration, and creativity. Responsibility and leadership abilities are developed and nurtured. These are the very traits that colleges and employers expect students to possess upon graduation from high school. The inevitable abilities and friendships that result, they're a bonus. Theater and the arts specifically address learning standards. As you know, New Hampshire's Department of Education has a system in place to ensure that schools throughout the state offer, quote, the opportunity for an adequate education. This input-based school accountability system, or IBAS, uses surveys and site visits to guarantee that schools provide learning opportunities for students in each of 12 adequacy standards. In addition to literacy, mathematics, and the sciences, arts education is included prominently among the 12. It was nice to be able to discuss the value of the CSA theater program during November's IBAS site visit to Fisk, and the members of the visitation group responded with enthusiasm. At the end of the month, Holly Goldberg Sloan, the acclaimed author of Counting by Sevens, will publish a new children's novel, and it is wonderful. In the new book, Short, readers meet middle schooler Julia Marks. When her little brother auditions for a summer production of The Wizard of Oz, Julia's mother suggests that she try out too in order to be able to keep an eye on her brother. This despite the fact that Julia doesn't really sing or dance well, and she's very short for her age. Julia is more surprised than anyone when she is cast as a munchkin. One of my favorite scenes comes near the end of the book, which is also the end of a life-changing summer for Julia. Having intended to for months, she finally acknowledges her mom. "Thanks, Mom. Thanks for making me try out for the play." Julia doesn't anticipate her mom's reaction. "I think I might just have made being a mother worthwhile for her. I will try never to forget her face. It's too bad I don't have a cell phone because I could have taken a picture. Mom's got tears in her eyes and she's smiling. It's an amazing look. I have to remember how powerful it is to say thank you, especially to the people you live with. They probably least expect it." So it won't ruin the story to tell you that Julia, while remaining small in size, grows plenty by the time the play finishes its run. It is a satisfying realization. Still, this is a novel, and we expect happy endings. We know that not every kid will experience a transformation like Julia's, and that's okay. Julia wasn't the star of her show either. But early in the book, Julia shares this observation. Quote, "One thing I've decided is that life is just one big, long struggle to find applause. Participation in theater can provide success and acceptance regardless of one's role. Doing theater, like so many other worthy endeavors, means being part of a team, working together to achieve something of value. And best of all, despite all of the work and the stress, it is rewarding and fun to be part of a play." Julia is charming for sure, but she's fictional. Very shortly, you will hear from some real-life members of the Fisk team. They're eager to share their experiences in children's stage adventures. You will be dazzled. For me, watching these performances over the last 5 years, with many more to come, has been utter privilege. My role is spectator, and yet I'm genuinely thrilled to witness it all, and I'm filled with pride. The enthusiasm, commitment, and talent shown by all involved are inspiring. Just one more quote from Short. The play's director reminds us, quote, "Poets and painters and performers ask us to examine what we see and feel and hear. We're asking people to take another look at themselves and at each other. This is a convincing expression of art's immeasurable worth." The board already knows that the arts are important. You and the Salem community have put incredible investment into arts education. We hope that our efforts here at Fisk, combined with others throughout the district, will help to keep Mr. Cassidy and his team very busy and ensure that the Seifert Performing Arts Center is constantly active and booked for decades to come. Thank you. And now, on with our show. It is my pleasure to invite Lisa Chevert to the podium. She has participated in the last three CSA productions, last year as the princess. And so, Your Majesty.
Thank you for hosting us tonight. I will be talking to you about the CSA program that the Fisk School participates in. The first play that I attended was The Emperor's New Clothes, and I was in second grade. It was so exciting. When we try out, I kind of just let go and have so much fun. After we try out, they pick our parts, and it is super exciting too. Then we have a week to practice. We get to say our lines over and over again. I just could not wait till Friday when we perform at the Salem High School. We all get our own costumes and our own makeup. At first, I was a little scared to get up in front of all those people. But now, I can just get up there and do what they taught me. It gave me a chance to go inside of myself and pull out a whole different me. It also taught me that you should always take a chance and try something new. If you really try, you will improve, like how I was a horse and I had not a lot of lines in my first play. And last year, I was the princess in The Princess and the Pea, and I had a lot of lines. I really love the CSA program. You will now be viewing a video with two current Fisk students, Marcus and Kelsey, and a former Fisk student from Salem High School, Denali. They will share their thoughts about being part of CSA. Thank you.
So Monday afternoon is tryouts, and the interested students all go to the gym together at the same time and have a tryout for different parts. So the actors really are zoning in on what kinds of roles they're looking for, and students that maybe are just ready to be in the chorus versus a lead role.
Over the 5 years that I have been a part of the CSA play, it's been really, really, really fun for me to have this play in my life. From being a kindergartner, small part, nervous, not really sure what a CSA play is, like scared, will they like me? Will they hate me? Like, what will they do? To now a fourth grader, ready to be on stage, wanting to be the best that I can, confident, and now being a fifth grader, I want the biggest part there is. Like, if we're doing Oliver Twist, I want to be Oliver. If we're doing Princess and the Pea, I want to be the princess.
So Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday is really all about rehearsal and learning their parts and learning how to use the props and what it means to be on stage and how to speak clearly.
I was in all 5 CSA performances at this school. In kindergarten, I was a starfish in Fisherman and His Wife. First grade, I was a mouse in Andrew Cleese and the Lion. In second grade, I was a school kid in The Emperor's New Clothes. And in third, a Londoner in Oliver Twist. Fourth grade, I was a lady-in-waiting in The Princess and Pea. And this year, fifth grade, I want to be a big role in Shakespeare's Midsummer Dream.
On Tuesday, we start with practices. And practices happen throughout the day, mainly during the afternoon and then after school as well.
In second grade, I was in the chorus for The Emperor's New Clothes, and we were off to the side. We were wearing a cowboy hat and cowboy boots. And after the tryouts for third grade for the play, it was Oliver Twist, and I got Oliver, and I was so happy, and I was a little nervous and surprised, and I was nervous when it was the day of the play, and it was much different from having a smaller role in the chorus to have a much bigger role in the third grade. In third and fourth grade, I had 2 lead roles. In third grade, I was Oliver in Oliver Twist, and in fourth grade, I was a king in Princess and the Pea. I love to be on stage acting, and this year I hope to get another lead role, and in middle school, I hope to participate and get lead roles.
On Friday is our performance day, and for the past few years, what we've been able to do is have 2 performances. So our afternoon performance is during the school day, and the entire school is able to watch the performance.
So as a fifth grader at Mary A. Fisk School, I participated in the CSA, and one of the shows I performed in was Androcles and the Lion, and I loved it in general because a bunch of my friends were in it and I got to make new friends, and it just overall inspired me about how the creativity and how you could express yourself in different ways over the whole like show, and like how every single role was different, and even though you had a specific role, you could show yourself in many different aspects, and that made me want to continue during middle school. So I performed in Alice at Wonderland and The Lion King at Woodbury, and then now I am a freshman in high school and I am in tech doing Cinderella.
In order to make this work, we do have special schedules where we are able to allow the students that wish to participate to not miss out on, you know, the other parts of their academic day. Along with that, we also really dedicate the whole week just to CSA. So after school clubs and enrichment programs don't happen that week. And we really spend a lot of time just getting ready and making sure that we can run it as smoothly as possible, but also that the students are able to get out of it as much as they possibly can.
Well, I hadn't experienced and wasn't as influenced as I am now to continue theater. And if I didn't have the whole like process and experiences that I did have, I probably wouldn't have made the friends and just overall became in love with theater in general.
Each year it's just been great to see the difference in the kids from when we start on Monday to when they are ready for performance day on Friday. And then Friday night is sort of our friends and family night. And the children all really enjoy having a big audience and just getting up on stage and showing what they've learned throughout the week.
As you can see, we really enjoy CSA at Fisk. This year, we are very much looking forward to our CSA week again. We'll be performing the play, an adaptation of the play, Shakespeare's Midsummer Night's Dream. That'll be on April 14th. And we are very excited to be here this year again in the new Performing Arts Center. As you saw in the video, we were for 2 years at Fisk in our all-purpose room and 2 years in the auditorium here, and 1 year at Woodbury. So this will be really exciting for us. So that's it, if you have any questions.
I'll start out. This is kind of exciting. I had no idea that this program was taking place at this school, none. So I'm kind of looking forward to April 14th now.
Great.
I mean, I've heard the expression artist in residency used a lot through the years, but I never really knew what it was until tonight. So I'm learning something every day, it seems, as a school board member. Your presentation was wonderful tonight, and it really looks like a wonderful program. Any other board members? Mrs. Corbett.
Well, thank you very much for coming. As usual, I'm amazed at what you brought to us. So I think I'm dazzled, as Mr. Rose said that I would be. And I guess I have a couple of questions. First, I'm just thrilled with the skills that the kids are learning as they're doing this, and it's academic skills, but also those social skills, and they're making friends and learning how to collaborate, things like that. So that's so impressive. But I'm just wondering too, like, so how's the play picked, selected? And I know you have it ahead of time, but then do they bring costumes and scenery, or do you make that too?
So the company, Children's Stage Adventures, we basically a year ahead of time, we book with them, and then we hear from them a few months prior to our date, and they choose the play for us, which play we'll be getting. And then they assign us two actors to spend the week with us, and they pretty much bring all the main parts that we'll need. So the majority of the costumes, they'll ask the students to wear a certain color pants and a certain color shoes. And sometimes they have to add, you know, one more piece of their own. And the majority of the props they travel with as well. Once in a while, the kids will have to be part of making something. But most of that stuff they travel with, and then the students are part of setting it up and breaking it down and, you know, learning how to use it and all of that.
Great. And as always, I'm always amazed at how our staff pulls together for these things, because it's definitely above and beyond their daily job, and I know that's a ton of work. So thank you.
Any further questions or comments? Mr. Campbell?
Yeah, I'm thrilled for the program, performing arts, and particularly the theater with my family, and I know my son is probably looking forward to working with that young lady, because that's what he leads, the tech side of the Cinderella production at Salem High School now, and he's thrilled to be part of that and looking forward to working in the Seifert Performing Arts Center. So this afternoon I booked my tickets for Cinderella, so I can put my plug in. For the tickets for the event, my wife and I went online today and ordered our three tickets to Cinderella's Saturday performance. I understand we have a new system this year that you can go online and book those tickets, and we're doing reserved seats. So now's the time to get in on the ground floor for Cinderella tickets, I understand. And they'd love to have some early bookings, because I understand if they get some early bookings, they can get a head start on some of their props and materials. So it's wonderful, and I look forward to it.
Speaking of our performing arts studio, our performing arts
center.
We are having an opening for that, and I have to say a few words, and I was wondering, Mr. Rose, can I plagiarize your whole speech, because it was really nice. I thought, wow, why don't I just let you get up there and speak? You like summed it all up really well. Would you like to say that?
Absolutely. I would like to say a few words. First, I'd like, Mr. Murray, could you come up and just, I have a couple of questions. I just want to.
Sure.
So how is this program funded? Because there's a cost to have these teachers in residence come, and you save some money by having them live with family members, but still there's a burden on the families that host these teachers, and then there's an expense associated with the program itself.
Sure. So there is a significant cost associated with the week program. We work with our PTA, who historically, over the past 5 years, has funded the majority of the cost for the program. This past year, we had some staff members who worked with the PTA to actually fundraise and approach local businesses who were more than willing to make some donations to our PTA. And then the PTA ultimately paid for.
So about how much does this cost?
We are $2,600.
$2,600, and you've done this for 5 years now.
Exactly.
So more than $10,000 for your PTA. So it's an effort to raise the money or to solicit businesses to contribute in some way. And Mr. Rose, in his presentation, mentioned the academic benefits for students that get involved in the performing arts, either drama or music in some way. There is increased verbal scores, increased math scores. So there is a benefit to the school district, wouldn't you say, for kids to be involved in a production like this?
I would certainly agree. And each year, this program continues to grow. Last year was our best attended event of the five. We had more than half of our student body from K to five participate in the program. We've been able to accommodate all of the students, so any student that wants to participate is able to be part of the performance. So we're excited for.
Okay, so and if there's a residual benefit to the school district because students have the opportunity to improve their verbal and math scores on any kinds of assessments, there is also a tangential benefit to the community for having students that are more numerate, more literate, and probably taking their skills to a completely different level as they move from the elementary school to the middle school to the high school. And Fisk students are advantaged by having your PTA invest this money.
We certainly believe so.
So perhaps there could be a proposal, since we want our Performing Arts Center used to its fullest, there would be a benefit perhaps to proposing that the school district absorb the cost of the production, and perhaps it could then also spread to other schools as well, and all our students would have the opportunity. So thank you for answering my questions.
And we would be happy to make that proposal.
Okay. Okay. I want to mention, Lisa, you did a fantastic job standing up here and talking about your own experience. It takes a lot of courage to stand up here and live in front of everyone and be so poised. So congratulations to you. And the other students that appeared on the video, I think, are outstanding examples of the kids at Fisk and our community. And I want to congratulate them as well, and the entire Fisk community for going out of your way to make this kind of experience available to the students. I know there are key people that make these kinds of things happen, but not everybody can have the big speaking roles, right? Some people are members of the ensemble or the chorus and all those parts, or the tech crew and all those parts are as important, just as important. I would not want to be the one that had to select the ones for the big parts as they get a little older. I imagine the kindergarten students aspire to be part of the crew or the chorus, and then gets a little bit more involved as they get a little older and can memorize more lines. But I know some of the students seem to be able to memorize lines as early as third grade. So thank you very much. This was wonderful and quite a testament to the staff at Fisk School and the families at Fisk, how much you do and the extent to which you go to provide opportunities for all your kids. So thank you very much for coming here and sharing with us tonight. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you all again for coming in. This is kind of ends the portion of the meeting that you're part of. So if you'd like to leave, you're welcome to do that, or you're welcome to stay for the rest of our meeting.
This has been a Salem School District Media Services presentation.